In this video I'll show you how to make the belly belt and pouches. For this tutorial I'm going to use a material called Wonderflex. And here I have a little sample, and it's just at room temperature, it just feels like plastic. But once heated you can bend it in every shape you want, and as soon as it cools down it will stay into that shape. And I have a sample. Here I have just an air dryer, and I will heat it up. And now you see it's very flexible, it's almost like a piece of cloth. And there are actually two sides. This side is pretty smooth, and this side has some grids, as you can see. So if you want to stick it together, you can just push it on each other and maybe reheat it again. And let's say you want it into this shape, and now you have to let it cool it down. And now it will stay into that shape. Now let's get started. Here I have some templates, and here you can see the full template of the insignia. And I made some additional templates, and they are all from the same design. So here I have the outside and inside, and this is just the kind of, well, I don't know, kind of emboss. And here we have only the outside and only the inside. And this tutorial is all about layers. We are just going to stack a piece of Wonderflex on each other, so a nice insignia will form out of Wonderflex. Although we're going to use Wonderflex for most of the time, I still add a layer of metal just to give it some strength. And here I have that sample again that I formed earlier, and as you can see it's staying to shape, but it won't hold any strength or forces. I mean, it still bends. So I'm going to use one layer of metal, so it's still got the strength and can hold a belt, for example. For the metal layer I will use this template, the outside and inside. I already made the shape onto the metal, and I'm going to cut it out using my Dremel. Alright, we have our metal layer, and next I'm going to use fire extinguisher. You can use any round thing to bend it into shape, because it's straight right now, and if you put it onto your belly it won't fit that nice, so I will bend it a bit so it will follow the curves of my belly. Fire extinguisher. I use some cardboard to protect the paint against scratching. Now just a bit. Side and bend it some more on the table, and this looks good. And you just want so it will follow the curves of your belly. So from now on I'm going to use Wonderflex to form the insignia. Here I have a pretty big roll of Wonderflex. And I It's actually a bit too big, but I'm going to try anyway. There we go. Now I let you work. Now I lay it onto the Wonder Flex and don't exactly draw a line around it, just something like that. And we make, actually, let's save some of this stuff by doing this. That works better, it will save you some on the flex. And do the same here. Something like that. And now you can just use some scissors to cut out the Wonder Flex. There we go. And now lay this to the side. So now, here we have the back side. Now I'm going to make sure the side with the grit on it is on the inside. And it should fit, because we just measure it out. This is the way it should go. And let's see how I'm going to do this. Like that, and now. Hair dry and heat up the stuff. Alright, it's pretty much cooled down right now and it won't really stick to the metal, so we have to keep it into place somehow. I hope by hand will just work. And now lay another piece of Wonder Flex on top and let that melt over it, so those edges will join together, and then trim the excess material off and you have your metal into the Wonder Flex. And now, while keeping it in place, we have to let it cool down. Alright, that's pretty good. And now we can trim off the excess Wonder Flex. So now we have a nice insignia with the metal plate inside. And that way it's nice and strong. So this is our base, and I'm already going to attach a belt to it. And the belt I have here is not really looking like in game, but it's good enough for me. And we're going to attach the belt first, because we are going to make some holes and punch them, not punch, but put some rivets inside. And since this is the base, we will add another layer on top of it, and that way the rivets will be hidden under the layers. This belt consists of small sections and they are held together by some kind of leather parts. And I will try with my scissors to cut the thread of it, and that way I can make the loose ends and attach them to the insignia. So let's see how well this works. I managed to remove this part, so now I have four loose ends. And if I get my insignia base, we will make two loose ends on the bottom. And two loose ends are going to be on the top. So first, we're going to drill some holes right here, and here, and here. and then we can add the belts to it using some rivets. So now we have four holes into the insignia base, and we also made some holes into the belt ends using a punching client. And next I will use rivets and put them through the belt like that, and then through that hole put the cap on. Oh, sorry, it's coming off again. And then, using some rivet tool, which is hollow on the inside, and a plastic hammer. So now we have a belt that will stay onto the base. Now first do the top part, because as you can see the bottom part needs to be shorter. So if you do that bottom part first, it will, well, go like this. So first do the top part, and then the bottom part you can cut it down to the size you need, and then secure it to the bottom. But first we top. Now you might want to drill another hole next to the bottom holes, because if you do only one hole, it will do the same as above here. It can still twist around, which is what you don't want. You want that bottom part to be straight. So I will drill another hole next to these, so that way it will keep it straight. So now we can add another rivet. So now we have a good belt attached to the insignia base. Next I'm going to use some craft foam. And I do that because I want to give the insignia some thickness. And this stuff isn't really thick enough. So we will use craft foam on the inside, the same as we did with the metal blade. And let's say we pick up maybe 5 or something. And stick them together. And then I will use this template, the outside, as I call it, and lay it onto the craft foam. Maybe even stick it to it. That should work. And make it a pen and trace the outside. And then cut out that shape. Now we have 5 layers of where's the template? This template. And once you cut out the inside, which is this, you might want to keep this because it will be handy soon in the next step. Now let's get this and remove, like, I don't know, 2 or 3. Let's take 3 layers. Get this tape off. Isn't that nice, all these colors? Anyway, Let's take three layers and stick those together at this point. And on the opposite side as well. And maybe even here. Like that. And now draw a line so these ends will be cut off. Also do it on this side. Something like that. And now trim those off. And now we have these on the bottom. This one is upside down. That. Like so. And now also stick those together. And now take your base and lay this on top of it, and then we will use another piece of Wonderflex to melt around it. Alright, that's our first layer of Wonderflex, and lay this aside for a while and get two of the inside pieces you just cut out. And one piece is already okay, and the other has to be like this template. And I will draw it by hand real quick. And then wrap some Wonderflex around these. And now you can stick it to the insignia. And now we have our inside layer. Next I will make some engravings, you see right here. And originally I also wanted these curling engravings, but those are too small to make. So I will skip them for now. And to make those lines, I will reheat this part and use this knife, which is made to engrave leather. I will use a knife to make some lines in it. And to make those circles right here, I will just use my rivet tool. And while I was busy, I came up with this idea. I took some solid copper wire and bent it into this curl shape. And now I can make those curl engravements. Alright, not the best result, but it's better than nothing. Next I'm going to make the emblem on top and the leaves. And this step is pretty simple. Here we have the emblem. And you just get a piece of foam again. Lay the top, make a copy onto the foam. And you do the same for the leaves. You need 26 leaves. And for the leaves you might want to stack together the foam sheets. And just cut it out once and you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 leaves at once. And next get some walnut flax and lay the foam leaves and the emblem on top of it. Don't too close to each other. Don't do this, but something like this. And then get another piece of walnut flax. And lay it on top. And then heat those parts together. And now you can cut out all those shapes. Now I will reheat those leaves and make some engravements using this knife again. And now I will use this template as a guide to attach all those leaves to the insignia. The leaves are attached to the insignia, and that means we are pretty much done with the walnut flax. And next I'm going to cover up the belt and paint the insignia with a metal colored paint. Alright, we gave our insignia a metal color. And while I was painting, I realized that I forgot the engravements right here and the curls on the side. And luckily I managed to attach those curls and make some engravements after painting. So you have to do this before you're going to paint. Just keep it in mind. And next I have what's supposed to be looking like a crystal or something. And I made it out of plastic and just sand it so it got a little crystal texture. And I will attach it to the insignia with some transparent glue. Alright, we have a crystal onto our insignia. And that means we are done with the insignia and the belt. So now you can put it to the side and move over to the pouches. For the pouches I will use a few templates. For example, here we have the medicine pouch. There you go. This is the middle pouch, and we will also make this kind of piece and it will kind of wrap around. And here we have the white pouch that's almost on the right, and we will make a copy of all those templates onto a piece of leather. And now I will paint all the parts brown using some penetrating leather paint. And since I'm using penetrating paint, it will also appear on the other side for leather. So if I paint this side, the color will also appear on this side without actually painting it. Which is kind of nice, because you will see the inside once it's completed. And next, I will sew the parts together. And the method of sewing is not the same on every part, because here we have the medicine pouch, for example. And we will just stack the leather pieces together and sew it along the edge and then you have these flap which will close it up. But let's take the small pouch for example. We will get the bad side for leather, or I call it the bad side, it's the rough side, and we will keep it on the outside as you see, and then we will sew it along the edge. And once you sew it, you can flip it inside out and the good side will appear, and it will make the overall look a bit nicer. And we do the same for the white pouch, so you also sew it with the rough side on the outside and then flip it inside out. And this piece is for this, as we said earlier, but we will come to this later. Alright, the pouches are sewed together, and here we have the medicine pouch, and as you can see, the smooth side of the leather is already visible. But these two pouches, we have the rough side of the leather. So now we have to, or at least try, to put them inside out, and it's pretty hard to do because leather is a pretty stiff material. There we go. And now I have to do the same with the other. Alright, that took some time, but I finally flipped it inside out. And if you're having trouble with it, you might want to make the leather a bit wet, because when leather is wet, it's more flexible than it's dry. And you see it kind of won't stay into shape, so maybe when you finish these, you have to put some maybe some heavy books on it or something, just to get them into shape. Now if we take a look at these templates, which are from this white pouch and the medicine pouch, we will see that there are some, let's see if I can show you, some dot lines, and those lines are engravements, so you have to make engravements on this one, this one. And if I just take a pencil, you can, let's start with this one, just draw them on by hand, just real quick. You don't have to make them perfect, but just something like that. And now you can make some engravements. It's not perfect, but it will work. And the reason why I do this after I paint it is because where you, or at least I used Dremel with a sand wheel attachment, and if you do that, the engraved lines will be lighter than the other parts, which is kind of nice. So now we can do the same with the other pouch. And now we have some engravements. Now I'm going to cover up the pouches using some painter's tape, because we are going to paint the edges using some spray paint. I don't cover this pouch, the small middle one, because we won't paint the edges of this one. Instead, we will use all around this part. And here I have some spray paint, which is silver color, and we will carefully spray the edges. And now we can remove the tape. And now we have a nice silver edge. Alright, now lay the medicine pouch and the white pouch to the side for a moment. And move over to this part and the small pouch. Because here I have a little buckle and strap. And I will make the buckle right here underneath. Then I will try to attach it to the little pouch right on top. Let's punch some holes first. And then this layer is going to be on top, and then comes the belt, and then the small pouch, and I will, let's see, secure it with rivets. So put it in here, maybe another one. And then belt, or buckle I mean. And then this part. Oh. Put the cap on. And then, sorry for that. Using my rivet tool, and where's my hammer? Right here. You can put them into place. That. And now we will make the strap to this side. And now we can close the pouch. Now for the other two pouches I have two D-rings and some more straps. I will put these straps around, punch some holes right here and right in this flap, and then attach it behind like that. And now we have two D-rings onto the pouches. And when I look in game, I can't discover anything that's attached to these rings. They just hang down like this. And since this leather is still a bit stiff, it won't stay down. So once this tutorial is finished, or once this part is finished, I will put some heavy books on it and leave it like this overnight. And hopefully it will stay into shape. Now get back your belly belt. And now attach those pouches to the belly belt with this in the middle and the white one on the right and the medicine pouch on the left. And I will just attach them using some rivets. After you attach the pouches to the belt, you are done. This was my belly belt and pouches tutorial. Thanks for watching.